We don't have any strategy. Maybe we talk about later in our room with Denkop. But yeah, I think of course the schedule is clear. First the 2D benchmark and then the 3D benchmarks. And I think we should test both CPUs and during testing CPUs to prepare and modding the cards. And after that, I think there are 5 hours for 3D Mark 11. And should be enough to test both cards, and yeah, I think that's the main strategy. And of course, the best strategy is to make the best scores.
Yeah, the strategy is to win, that's everything. So I'm quite fine with it when I win. But now, to be honest, it should be the goal to break some records. And not only on Saturday, maybe on Sunday also, with more than one card. So we'll see what happens.
Our strategy, yeah. Don't really have one, and we will see with the hardware, and we will improvise, I think.
I think, as always, we will try to make every benchmark one time with a low clock, to be sure we have scored for every benchmark, and then we'll try to start to increase frequency and push voltage more and more until we kill the hardware or we have the maximum of the hardware. But to start, we will try to make every benchmark one time with low frequency.
We will try to insulate that both cards and test it as quickly as we can. And I hope to have luck with a good CPU, because I think it's critical to have a good CPU. And I hope to have some luck.
Max CPU frag, max GPU frag, and we are ready to win.
Neutral.
Tomorrow the strategy, I think, really is Roman's expertise is obviously in the hardware modding. So he'll be doing the hardware modding while I'm doing the CPU binning, if you like, so we can pick out, and then I'll also then when he's finished the hardware modding, I'll be doing the insulating, and then we'll try and bin the cards quickly on air, and maybe even run a couple of benchmarks on the CPUs on air, just so we pull out the right hardware that we're going to start with, and hopefully not waste too much time during the actual competition trying to figure out what's the best hardware to use.
The strategy mainly is to do the Cinebench first, test both CPUs, take the best CPU for 3D, and then just get the cards to run high clocks and keep the CPU actually low on clocks for 3D, and yeah, just see how it goes. It's always about luck, you know, that if you do a hardware lucky draw, so yeah.
So we'll try and pick quickly. When we've done that also, we'll try and get everything insulated and so on and so on. If we do hit problems, we can run a second rig or a second card fairly quickly without having to stop everything, warm up, change pots, change this, change that. So we'll try and keep our time management, you know, as fast as possible.
All the benchmarks start at the same point, and then Cinebench closes quite quickly, and then there is a lot more time for the other benchmarks, which close 1 hour apart. So it's going to be the strategy of, I think, figuring out all of your safety scores and then trying to optimize for each of the benchmarks as they close. The problem is that the closing between the 3D benchmarks is only 1 hour. So if your setup is unstable in, let's say, the second 3D benchmark and you still have to finish the last one, yeah, you're going to have to make sure that you have some good scores up front as well. So it's going to be strategic as well, I think. Yeah.